guys, so today I'm teaching my friend Ness how to cook. Let's do this. Yay. All right, so y'all might remember Ness from the recreated Nikki Tutorials makeup tutorial that we did. And today I'm getting a little revenge. She has no idea how to cook at all. Trust me, we lived together for a year. She has no idea how to cook. So today I have found a recipe and she is going to make it for us. However, because this is a girl who lives off of fast food, I didn't want to send her body into like shock. So I looked up and found the recipe to Taco Bell chicken quesadillas.
Totally in my wheelhouse.
Yes. All right, so I have my trusty laptop here. We have the recipe pulled up. Vanessa, do you know how to read a recipe?
Sort of, except some of these words, I don't know what they mean.
I'll help you.
That's where you're.
Just think of me as your Sherpa.
I mean, this one seems pretty easy. Combine sauce ingredients and stir until smooth. I think I can do that.
All right. Well, first we need to know what the sauce ingredients are.
Okay. So we've got 1/4 a cup mayonnaise.
Is it 1/4 or 1 1/4?
1/4.
All right.
All right. I had to check though.
Do you have your bowl?
Yes.
Alright, now one of these is 1 cup and one of these is 1/4 of a cup. Do you think you can distinguish?
I don't know how do you scoop mayonnaise out of the thing? This is not gonna be graceful. No, that's not happening. Okay, we're gonna get a
scoop. No, you just scoop.
It doesn't even fit in there.
Okay, let's get a scoop. And you want it to be like all the way up. You know, we're gonna want a lot of mayonnaise because any good authentic Mexican recipe calls for mayonnaise, right?
Yeah, I wouldn't know nothing about that. This is where it's challenging already. I don't think that mayonnaise was ever meant to be put into 1/4 cup. It's so like weirdly gelatinous that it's not like, you know, like filling.
Are you just making excuses for the fact that you cannot scoop mayonnaise into from one utensil?
I think that's perfect.
All right.
You can judge me, but
okay, we're good. Let's just make on this.
All right, in the bowl.
Okay, now you usually you just you're like,
oh.
So we have the mayonnaise in the bowl.
Yep.
I'm gonna put this back in the fridge.
Okay.
What's the next?
2 teaspoons of minced jalapenos. Slices.
All right, so this is when you're gonna have to cut.
No, they're already cut. Oh, wait.
No, you have to mince. Okay, so slice is different than mincing. Mincing is where you like.
Why does it say 2 teaspoons minced jalapenos, comma, slices?
Jalapeno slices. I don't know, just don't read too much into it. Okay, I'm gonna open this for you. Okay, I'm not sure how much 2 teaspoons is gonna be, so you're just gonna pull a bunch out and you're gonna chop them so that they're minced, like in really tiny little. What? Okay, just use your hands. What are you doing?
I don't feel comfortable.
Do show you what mincing is?
Shoving my fingers into this jar of jalapenos.
Oh,
yes, please.
So you're just gonna.
Oh yeah, I'm definitely not gonna cut my fingers off. You are correct.
And then you take that.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
So get to mincing.
Mm. Okay.
Where's our? How many do we need? 2 teaspoons.
2 teaspoons.
All right. You hand me our little teaspoon thing, and I'll start gathering them and putting them in here so that we can.
Teaspoons is.
TSP.
This is like weird.
That is, you're a smooth operator with that knife.
Oh yeah, I'm just focusing really hard on not cutting the tips of my fingers off.
All right, so the jalapenos were minced and they are in with our mayonnaise. What's next?
2 teaspoons of jalapeno juice.
Okay, your teaspoon.
I can do this part.
Well, yeah, I'm not doing this for you. Let's see if she can get liquid into a.
From a container into another container. Huzzah!
Yay! I guess it's just because jalapeno juice isn't gelatinous. So we're done with those, I believe?
Yes.
What's next?
Okay. 3/4 teaspoon sugar.
Alright.
Okay. Sugar So how do you measure a 3/4 of a teaspoon?
You eyeball it. You want that thing 75% full. Hold on though. Let me get a paper towel, because we're gonna want to get the moisture off of that so that the sugar doesn't stick. Let me see your teaspoon.
Thank you, ma'am. I used to bake when I was younger, but I didn't like cooking.
Like with Play-Doh?
No, like real stuff. I used to make funnel cake and cookies and, yeah. So that's been a while.
That's shocking.
That was a lifetime ago.
All right. You want that thing 75% full.
That's stupid.
25% empty. That's math.
Yeah.
Even though we're girls,
fractions,
we can still do math.
I would say this is 3/4 a teaspoon.
Whatever, I'm blind, I can't tell.
Just the way I like it.
All right. Next.
All right.
So we just put the sugar in.
Yes. So now we need a 1/2 teaspoon cumin.
All right.
One of these.
Which
one? I don't know what any spices are.
I mean, you can read, can't you?
Yeah, but I'm just talking about like I don't know what this tastes like. I would never be able to eat a dish and be like, oh wow, there's cumin in this. Like, I would never know.
It's kind of like, you know when something tastes like it has like taco seasoning in it, kind of?
Oh, okay.
That's cumin.
Do you open this whole thing and then take the or do you just stab a hole? How do you do it? Oh yeah, you gonna break it. Let me use an
I got
okay.
It!
Okay. Teamwork.
I don't believe there was much team at all.
I
well, you did peel it up, and you kind of peeled it up.
I supervised.
Yes. Supervised. This is how long it takes us to get 1/2 teaspoon of cumin.
Okay. I probably shouldn't measure it.
No, don't measure it over the bowl.
That's probably a rookie mistake.
Just measure it over the counter. Just
that's
freewheeling right over. Yep, not a problem.
Okay, that's not half. This is scary. I should probably use my dominant hand for the shaky hand.
I feel like these are things I shouldn't have to tell. I know it's like before showing someone how to cook, I should have to ask which hand is your dominant hand.
Listen, I'm trying here. Now I'll know how to make Taco Bell quesadillas. I don't know if this is half. Oh yeah, I just dumped some out. Now onto another 1/2 teaspoon of paprika. Okay.
All right, so we went ahead and opened the paprika off camera.
We're ready now.
Didn't think you need to watch us fiddle with yet another.
I can't describe how this one smells.
It smells like paprika.
It smells weird. Kind of like plants.
I wish I knew what paprika was, I'd tell you, but I'm not that knowledgeable.
Well, that's probably more. But we're gonna go with it.
Good.
I like the color of it.
Oh, that's important.
I figured. Okay. 1/8 teaspoon. Okay, now we're getting ridiculous. And
okay, what are the different measurements on here? What's that, a teaspoon?
There's probably, I bet you anything, there's 1/2 teaspoon on here. This was 1/2 teaspoon. Remember when I told you I used to bake, and it was a long time ago?
Okay, so I believe an 1/8 is less than 1/2.
Yes.
So
we need basically 1/4 of this one.
Yeah. 25%
of cayenne pepper. Mm-hmm. That's pepper. We're gonna put you over there, so I'll put you in here twice. Okay, cayenne pepper. This is the shaky top. Okay. That's it. Oh yeah, that was a good start. That's an 1/8. We're doing it. That's
I like it.
Bam.
I like it.
Okay.
I feel confident about that.
And 1/8 of garlic powder.
All right.
That's the last. Oh, no, there's a dash of salt. Just a dash. I like garlic powder, so we might put a little bit more of an 1/8 in here.
Sounds good.
You know, my eyeballs cannot tell if that's 1/4 of 1/2, so we're just going to say it's an 1/8. Cool. And a dash of salt.
Okay. So you're just gonna sprinkle some in your hand?
Fancy dash like a salt guy.
Well, no, because you have to put it in your hand.
Why?
Because it shakes out. We're using fancy Himalayan sea salt.
Ooh, it's like the pretzel salt.
Mm-hmm.
Is that a dash? Did I do it right?
The hurl.
I'm pretty sure you need to like.
Okay. Yes.
It might have been two dashes, but we got it.
We got it.
Good.
All right. So is that everything for the sauce?
Yes.
Now, what does it say to do?
Combine sauce ingredients and stir until smooth.
Okay, you're gonna want a fork.
Why?
Because that's the best way to smooth out.
It's not gonna be smooth. There's chunks of stuff in here.
Just
they're lying.
Just.
Also, this looks really gross when it got together. Oh. It smells like Taco Bell, though.
Uh-huh.
Change my mind. I lied.
And like, okay, so to make sure it like smooths out, you're gonna want to do that so like everything kind of runs through the tines of the fork. Yeah.
I didn't realize this stuff was made out of mayonnaise. I'm gonna make this stuff and put it on everything. You wanna smell it? It smells right. It smells like Taco Bell.
Because you got all the spices so accurately measured out.
Man, I'll have to invest in some of these
spices.
Alright,
I think we're smooth.
Okay. Next step, grilled chicken in vegetable oil and cut into thin slices. This is where we are gonna have some issues.
This is gonna be fun. Alright, so I do not have vegetable oil, but I do have olive oil.
Okay.
Does it say how much?
No. It does not. It just says grilled chicken and vegetable oil.
Okay, I'm actually gonna let you do that.
Oh no!
Oh yeah.
Well, I will.
Let me tell you this, with oil, less is more. The thing with cooking, you can always add.
Mm.
You can't subtract.
More?
Now, pick up the pan and kind of do like that so it goes all around the pan.
Okay, so maybe a little more. Just trying to.
Just don't put your hand on it and like wipe it around. Don't do that. Because that skillet's already hot.
There are some holes, you know, where it's not covered.
Okay,
it's
fine. Just put it back on.
Good.
Alright, now you want to grab our chicken.
I really don't like touching meat. I like eating meat, but I don't like cooking it.
So get ready to get handsy.
Although this feels pretty frozen, so maybe it won't be as gross because.
Oh dear, that's not great. Oh dear, it is frozen.
Is it like super frozen?
Mm-hmm.
Like unworkable frozen?
I understand.
Should we put it in the sink with some hot water?
Okay, our chicken's pretty frozen, so I'm gonna thaw it out in the microwave for a sec. Okay, so we got the chicken thawed out. So, back to where we were.
Okay, preheat skillet over medium heat. I think we did that.
Yeah. Alright, you're gonna be over there. You're gonna just, does the skillet still look shiny with oil?
Yes.
Alright, so you're gonna pick up these little chicken tenderloins, and you're just gonna,
with my hand.
Yeah.
How do I move it in my hand?
Okay.
What do I use?
God almighty. Right, just pick them up. Pick them up. Just get them in there first. Let's. That sizzle.
Start putting all of these?
Yeah, so the recipe calls for 4, and I'm doing 5 just to be on the safe side.
I don't think 5 will fit in here.
Alright, well, can you get one more?
No, you have 5.
Oh.
Yeah. Can I have a fork? So I can move these?
No, you're going to use a spatula. You don't need to move them yet, though. I mean,
I'm trying to move them so I can fit one.
Oh, gotcha.
Yay.
So, you're going to want to move them here and there so they don't get sticky to the pan.
There's still this little gross piece that was like
a
baby of one of them.
I thought you didn't even want to touch it. Now you're just holding them, huh?
It's not going to fit.
Okay, then just leave it. It's okay.
Okay, so what do I do?
All right, hold the spatula like a human.
Yeah.
And keep them on the side they're on right now.
Yeah.
Does it say how long to cook them?
No, it just says grilled chicken.
All right, so we're just going to grill.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, go stop it. So we are still grilling the chicken. So pick up your spatula. You're just gonna boil. So just try flipping one over?
Okay. Oh, maybe this little weird one. It looks like an animal.
Well,
hey!
I did it!
And should I flip them all over?
If you think you should.
I don't think that I should. I mean, this one feels like chicken, sort of. Is that enough?
Just flip them all over.
Sort of feel like chicken?
You're not going to know that until we cut into them.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to try not to ruin everything.
There's nothing to be ruined. You just have 5 little pieces of chicken in a pan.
That's a lot to ruin.
There's really nothing to ruin.
That's 5 pieces of chicken that have the potential to be ruined.
How would you ruin it?
I don't know. I don't know how this cooking thing works.
I mean, just like, don't spit in there, and I think we'll be okay.
Well, even if I did, you know, that would cook out. I'm really more concerned about, like, salmonella and...
Okay, I'm not going to let us get salmonella. We will overcook these chickens before we undercook them, I promise.
Okay.
Okay, just don't... Okay, why are you, like, not a normal human with utensils? Like, what? Like, I mean, you're just like... What? Have you ever helped things before? Okay, so we're calling the chicken done.
Yay!
Yay!
It looks like chicken!
Hooray!
Those are not quesadilla thin slices.
No, see, it looks like we have work for you to do after
all. We
washed
that. But all the chicken would just like pull apart, you know, as opposed to cut in thin slices.
So that's another trick. Oh, see, you're already teaching yourself things. Alright, so instead of using a knife, what you can do is you can use 2 forks.
Oh, I've seen people do this.
And
they like pull it apart.
Mm-hmm.
Should we do that instead of doing
it?
I think we should do that.
Yeah, I think you should do that.
Let's use this plate then instead of even though I just lost a piece. Well, one of your dogs is gonna get some chicken. And by one of your dogs I mean Lexi.
Oh my god.
It's just chicken. It could be worse.
I know, but that's chicken that we're not gonna get.
Well, that's why we put 5 pieces.
Alright, now those are 2 forks, so it shouldn't matter which is your dominant hand.
Seen people do it. I've never said I'd done it.
You shred the heck out of
it.
Yeah,
look at it. Shredded. This is gonna be better later. But
are you talking? I'm sorry.
I'm talking to myself.
Okay.
So it doesn't really matter if you listen to me.
Alright, good.
This is gonna take a while.
And an hour later, the chicken is now shredded.
Yay!
Alright, Miss Chef, what do we do next?
Lay tortilla into hot skillet and sprinkle with 1/4 cup of each shredded cheese and 1/2 cheese slice on one side of the tortilla.
I got it.
Yeah.
It's not that hard.
I just read it weird. So we're supposed to put 1/4 cup on each one of these babies? It's fine. You don't have to answer my question. We're just going to read this one together because... Arrange about 1/4 cup chicken slices over a tortilla on the same half covered with cheese. On the empty side, spread about 1 tablespoon of sauce. Fold over, press gently with spatula. Cook until cheese is melted and slice each into 4 pieces.
Do we
really need to measure 1/4 cup of cheese? Can't we just like sprinkle cheese on?
I mean, do you want to absolutely do less cheese?
No.
I don't.
That sounds sad.
Yeah.
Okay. This is a strange turn, though, that we're using sliced cheese.
Kraft singles. That's actually what it calls for.
This is the good stuff. This is
and then the other cheese it calls for is cheddar and Monterey Jack. Mm.
It's like gooey because, you know, it makes good grilled cheese sandwiches.
Mm.
Okie dokie.
Right.
Is that hot? Do we put anything on it? This says no, so no.
Okay. It's like, just answer your own question.
I just did that very lazily. Now I'm regretting it. Okay.
Alright.
So on half of it, where's the 1/4? So we're gonna put 1/4 of each type of cheese. Can you put that back up again? Because I need to read it as I'm going.
Oh, sorry.
I already know what I'm doing, but I'm gonna get cheese in the chicken because it's fine.
That's okay. I don't mind living in a world with extra cheese. I just don't want to live in a world with less cheese.
Okay. Good. So that's 1 cheese.
Great.
Another cheese.
Oh,
wait. Do we do 1/4 cup? It says 1/4 cup of each shredded cheese.
Yes.
So that's 2/4 cup total of cheese.
Well, 2/4
is correct.
Half. Okay, what kind did you put on?
I put on
the white one. Okay, so now just do 1/4 cup of the cheddar.
I was just making sure.
Are you just sticking your grimy hand up?
Okay. Coming from the girl who yelled at me about not just shoving my hands into the jalapeno container.
That's different. All right, now what do you do? smart. Like, really.
Okay. Half, it just says to put this on the same size.
And that's what you do.
It's melting. Oh, God. All right. I'm going too slow.
Yes, you are.
Fourth a cup of chicken slices.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm going to use my hands. Okay. That's insane. We have chicken. I'm going to spread it out.
It's dangerous.
You're just going so slowly.
I'm too logical and
no, I don't think that's your problem.
Look, listen, listen. It's coming out so good. Okay.
All right, now what?
Oh, we were supposed to chicken on the same side as the cheese. I'm messing it up.
Yes. Did you?
Oh God, I put it on the other side. Hold on.
The clock is ticking.
Ah!
Da,
da, da, da, da, da, da. Okay. Hold on. You keep doing it. It's helping.
Da, da. Meanwhile, everyone has just clicked out of this video.
No, it's amazing.
Now what?
Okay, now sauce.
What? How much?
Empty side. 1 tablespoon.
Is that the tablespoon?
That's a huge. We don't have that much sauce. What are they talking about? Spread with 1 tablespoon. This is just gonna get stuck in here. I don't appreciate you, tools. I don't appreciate you. This is
spread it out.
I'm gonna get a little more.
Yeah, that's cool. Fine. That's fine. Whatever you have to do. Great.
Okay.
And now?
We fold over and press gently with spatula.
Okay. Here's a clean spatula.
Gently. Okay.
And then you wait for the cheese to melt.
Okay. I probably should fold it over. Cook until cheese is melted and slice each into 4 pieces. That seems unnecessary. I know that's like the Taco Bell way to do it, but wouldn't you rather just eat this like a huge taco?
Yeah, we're not serving this to anyone except for ourselves, so.
We're gonna skip the step where you
cut
this. How do you know? How do you know?
How do you know what?
When the cheese is melted, I can't see it because now it's folded.
We'll try to lift the tortilla, and if it's hard to lift, it's melting to the other side.
This is making me really hungry, though.
I think I'm getting hangry. Like, I feel myself getting short with you. I'm like, just cook it! I just want to eat it!
Cook it now! Oh, I have to sneeze.
Okay, do not sneeze.
I think it's good. It could be wrong, but seems good. We're just gonna say it is.
Fabulous.
Don't burn your fingers.
It's not that hot.
Okay, now just 3 more.
They're finished.
Yay!
And one thing that you guys missed was Vanessa pulling up the skillet and like putting her face down by the burner, and I was like, what's the matter? And she's like, I don't know, I don't think your thing's heating up anymore. So I come around to the other side to figure out what's going on. She'd made an executive decision to turn the knob all the way down. And I said, the knob is all the way that way. And she's like, well, what does that matter? She didn't understand high, low. So after that, we got them cooked. I got myself some margarita poured. Oh,
now we just gotta try them and see if they're any good.
Yeah, do you think you could do this on your own?
Yeah. No, I lied.
All right.
Delicious.
Oh my god.
That sauce is so good. I'm gonna put that on everything.
So good. And one thing, if you guys want to try these, it said on the recipe to do the shredded cheese and then the half of the Kraft single. The Kraft single melts more slowly, so we ended up putting that down first on our last two and then doing the shredded cheese and then the chicken, and it helped. But these are
this is so good.
This is pretty amazing. So
this might actually be better than Taco Bell.
It might be. Hooray, we did it. And look, guys, the kitchen is not burned down.
Yay.
Mainly because Vanessa turned the burner to low.
Okay, this is easy. Just went ahead and cook the chicken. And don't turn the thing off. And also maybe practice.
Words of wisdom we can all apply.
Yay.
Bye.